Welcome back to Media in Focus. We're talking about Emir, the movie musical, with director Chito Ronyo, producer Digna Santiago, film critic Phil D, and Johanna Poblete of Business World. Direct Chito, you have directed many movies, among them Caregiver, which is also about nannies and caregivers, right? Mm-hmm. What makes that different from this one, well, as a story?
Well, una, Caregiver had Sharon Cuneta.
Okay.
And number two, it was really written as a melodrama, a drama about foreign workers who are caring for other people, leaving their families behind.
Mm.
It had a layer of a family life going to ruins. Personal, when the husband's relationship. It was more of that kind of a drama.
Mm-hmm.
Very familiar to the Filipinas and Filipinos.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of characters in it we researched in Europe. We integrated some of our materials into the story.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas Emir was primarily just about OFWs, using that as a backdrop. But it was really a musical script. It was not a script per se, but it was a story being told through music.
Mm-hmm.
Na we only use dialogue parang in between the singing.
To bring the pieces together. Okay.
So.
Did you think, Phil, earlier you said you found that the film Emir was plotless.
Mm-hmm.
When you compare Emir and Caregiver, for example, in terms of plot, which one did you find stronger?
Well, I found Caregiver stronger.
I have to agree.
Yeah, it was just a more complete film. It was more focused on the plight of a single person.
Mm-hmm.
And it just moved smoothly from scene to scene, basically. When we got to the end, we really felt it. And that's really the primary difference, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Emir, when we get to the ending, I'm not exactly sure why I should care about this joy, not to spoil anything, but
yeah.
This joyful reunion.
Okay, but as a new genre, as Chito is saying, is it effective, for example, for a Philippine audience to be introduced to this new kind of film? Does it open possibilities for the musical as film?
That's difficult to say because I don't think the industry can sustain films of this magnitude. The industry isn't in a place right now where it could make more musicals of this type.
Mm-hmm.
So it may stand out as like not every film will be able to get so much money from the government to continue to build these giant sets to get all these people together. So I don't think it will lead to more musicals.
Rare. You said it's rare.
So that's why you have the description as rare. Okay, Joanna, in your article at Business World, you said something about don't films like this promote the OFW phenomenon even further than it should be promoted.
Promotion, that's a good term for it, especially since this was endorsed by the government. I have to agree with Philbert. I liked Caregiver so much more because you were more emotionally invested in the character and you see the struggle, not just the external struggle of her occupation, but internally, everything, her conflict with the son, conflict with the husband, and all throughout. You see how she grows, how she develops, and how she comes to terms with her choices. Here, you don't.
Mm-hmm.
What you have with Amelia is, it's all superficial. Honestly, I'm really sorry, but you're whisked away into a fantasy world that if you really are paying tribute to OFWs here, you have to show the struggle, really, not show the rewards.
No, but Direct Chito here is saying that this was really written as a musical, and tied together by dialogue.
You can say that whatever method.
It's easy to say that, but you know, that's for me. I've done it. You know, the drama.
With all due respect, sir.
Yeah, I know what you mean, but you know, it's not. I'm saying that I'm not making excuses for Emir. For what it is there.
Mm-hmm.
No, but what I'm saying is, it's using now the language of a musical, which nobody here is really familiar with, especially Filipino musical, because. I even asked, sabi ko, when was the last original Filipino musical? Sabi ko, does that include, no, Zashas, no, ano pa ba yung mga
Kakababa?
Wanted Perfect? Because they were all...
It was in black and white.
No, darling. They were made for another... But originally, comics yun eh.
All right.
And it was written for stage, you know. Like, Wanted is also by Pablo Gomez. Okay. So it wasn't really written for the stage. It was how many months? Alam mo naman yung comics novela natin, di ba? Minsan how many months?
Serialized.
Yeah. Okay. So talagang the first musical that has been produced for such a long time, maybe even 40 years, is really Emir. That was really written for the stage, for the cinema.
Right.
Kasi the last one was Nick Johnson was telling me, I forgot, sorry ha. Mm-mm. But it was like unfamiliar. But maalaala mo kaya is the song. So you can
But does that open up possibilities, Digna, after having done Emir? Do you think that this opens up possibilities for musical movies?
Well, again, it's difficult with the certain probabilities now. But as FDCP and CCP would like to say that that's why we made this film. No ordinary producer would do this film.
Okay.
So we had to gamble to do this.
What's the takeaway from this film? What do you want the audience to take away?
Well, we are proud to have made this film that combined all the talents of theater, television, music, and film.
Mm-hmm.
We gave it the best state-of-the-art support from the Philippine Philharmonic to our Dolby to our red camera. We gave the best we could.
In terms of messaging, do you think it, as criticized, does it send the message that, yes, let's send more OFWs abroad?
Not necessarily. We just, as Direk Chita was saying, and as I think one of the comments was saying, that it has a bittersweet ending because after all, she came home. She might not have a family at the end, but there's a promise of a romance in the end.
But that's the thing. You're asked to be a martyr. A red martyr. Five of them actually died, and but that's okay because they're expendable already. Because they've gone through the whole 12 years where they've made a better life for their families. This is what you're telling these OFWs, and since you targeted service workers, they're the highest right now. They're the biggest occupation would be them, and the second would be nurses, and you placed it in the Middle East, and the top two countries interpret the message, which would be the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world, which I think is actually erroneous because it's almost like saying that all the yayas in the world should all be placed in households, powerful households.
All right, let's hear from Chito about
why did you kill them?
Kasi parang kinumbayan yung contest dun sa contest. Pero okay na lamang sa contest.
Okay.
But, anyway, who was your target, really, for this movie?
No, but but that whole comment about the yayas dying in the end, and that whole thing, that's really a part of my statement.
That's
really a part of my statement.
All right.
That this is something that something to the end, baka buhay mo is i-ano mo.
So that's the message there.
But it's not explored fully because what we have is a denoma, is some girl outside a church saying, oh, thanks for the memories, it's actually good after all the struggle, after all this time.
Well, she didn't say thanks.
Well, she didn't say thanks, but she said it's all right.
All right, on that note, I guess the debate continues, which really makes it more interesting for the viewers. Mm-hmm. Go see it. We'd like to thank Direk Chito, Digna, Phil, and Joanna for joining us tonight on Media in Focus. I'm Chacha Lazaro. We'll see you again next week. Good night.
Ibigay ko lang to kay Amelia.
Sa lumbay at lungkot, tagumpay ang magsumot.
Pag humihingi ng pera, mabilis makakonta. Ako naman tumatawag, wala man ng pakonsuelo.
Iniwan ako ni Victor.
Kinahasa ako ni Jamahan.
Tumawag ang nanay ko kanina at sinabi niya hindi daw nakapag-enroll ang mga bata dahil tinangay ni Tino at nangkabit niya lahat ng pinadala ko.
Naririto, nagtatanong ang puso ko. Natitinag, nangangamba, ito na ba?